That's actually my Forakel cloak that I have on for this character. Let me switch voice channels real quick. Let me switch screens here. Where's the splash screen? There we go. A hunt for the buried something or other. Your redeem store item. No idea what that was. Hundred percent mark acquisition. Apparently, I had one. Loading screen stuck. I'm going to talk to Atlee Spider-Bane, working on cleaning up some quests.
Well met.
Normal worm hunter. Lands, so North Downs. Up in North Rica. Okay, let's head to Estolin, and then from there to Orthocra.
How can I be of service?
This is unthinkable!
Greetings.
You don't hear any audio. Not bad, Dr. Mani. I'm just not talking very much. All right, where do we gotta go now? Octagon, Gondyad, where's that one at? Meters in that direction. Bonelands or Trollshaws? Rivendell. By the mailbox.
What can I do for you?
Ooh, I got some fishing to do tonight. Which reminds me, I still need to add that fishing app to the Titan bar.
How can I be of service?
Find the entrance to Heligrog.
How can I be of service?
How is everybody this evening? Up to 540 active members on the LOTRO Discord channel. Almost up to Heligrog. Now I gotta go to Baracken's camp. What else do I have on the list here? Anything else in Misty Mountains? Distant relations. Instances I have to complete. And Gander, I can add that back in. It's one that's instance based. Cancel that crafting one. Okay. Leithoth. Well, where is that? Fork shell. I have to go to Fork Hill for that? Oh, okay. So I gotta go to Kapakoda. Whatever. Here to Breland. The other one, Baracken's camp, so that's in the Trollshaws. Alright, let's ride down to Baracken's camp. So I don't have the Ostgaruth travel location yet. Slide down the hill here. Get some more data on fishing tonight.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Not many online, huh?
Nope. People don't seem to use the voice channels in here very often. I don't know why.
We're just streaming now?
Yep.
Okay, so if you want to stream.
You miss them all being late.
Hey, hey!
Hello!
Hey, Tech. Hey, Sean.
Hello, hello, hello.
Some audio adjustments here.
Yeah, very loud. I'm in a good mood.
Let's see if I can get this working.
I don't hear your in-game sounds.
Yeah, I can say the same. Can't hear your in-game sounds, but I can hear you typing and stuff like that. So
I don't know that I have in-game sounds on. Here I do. Just have them turned way down, I guess. We turn them up a little bit.
I've had the same issue today with my OBS. When I was streaming earlier, I was really struggling with, because I had the music playing and stuff like that on my Moo Bar. It was really struggling to pick up the music through the Explorer page, but I was getting game sounds and able to talk okay. It was really weird.
Now let me check your sound now.
There we go, that should be good. I just cranked it up a little bit. I had it set to 15% in Windows. I just cranked it up to 50.
Yeah, I can hear you now. I mean, the game I can hear.
And I cranked Discord down from 100 to 50, so that should balance that out. Alright, so I need to go to Brocken's camp.
Megovanen.
Thornhad.
So what's the same tune when I met you for the first time when you were streaming, or is it a different one?
I have no idea.
I saw so many Lord of the Rings online streams lately, oh my god.
I think I saw you on Mindstrom. Was it either today or yesterday or the day before, something like that, the last couple of days?
That could be. I'm streaming also other games than Lord of the Rings, but my PC is not compatible with streaming and heavy games. I mean, I played this afternoon Planet Coaster and I streamed it, and it was one lag fest, so no, I better stick with Lord of the Rings Online, that game I can run.
Yeah, best game going.
All right, why isn't that working? Let's see here.
And I really like the letter type that you use for your chat in your stream. When I try to do it, it's always so small and so not readable.
It took me quite a few different fonts and sizes to figure out something that worked.
And somehow your graphics look better in the Troll shows than mine. I mean, I cannot see the trees that far.
I always set my draw distance up to ultra, object draw distance. I turn everything else down in order to get ultra high for object draw distance. That's the one that makes it so you can see things really far away. Like the trees up on the hill or what have you.
I think it's quite kind of cool that you can have it on ultra, but yet sometimes you'll see it in the distance, you know that you're coming up on it, and then it will disappear, but then it will reappear.
Yep.
It's really funny the way it happens.
I get a kick out of it when it redraws things like that.
You know what also is strange is what I found out is that if you have the new regions, like Endwood and all stuff like that, they draw different than the old regions I have. I think, or it's just my mind, because the new regions look much more varied, how do you say it? Just different things. I mean, it's not looking so cartoony, you know?
And I think a lot of that's down to the coding that was used when the game first came out. That's part of the reason why they can't do Rift on, they can't get it so that Rift can be like a level 105 raid, because it was actually coded differently.
Yeah, I think so too, yeah. But when I was playing the beta almost 10 years ago, and I was first walking through the Shire, I was, oh my God, it looked like I was really alive there, you know? It was so lifelike. I was immediately hooked, and I called all my friends that I knew that also liked Lord of the Rings. I said, you really need to try this beta. It's unbelievable. And I got about 20 people hooked, so.
Cool.
I think it's still like that, to be honest. You know, a lot of it depends on your graphical settings and stuff like that, but I think it's still like that now. And, you know, people talk about, like, WoW and stuff like that. And, I mean, I've tried to go into WoW and I've never got into it. I don't like the cartoony look that you get with WoW and things like that. At least this game, you know, you do get that humanistic sort of element to it.
Did you also fall in love with Everdim?
Did I what?
Did you fall in love with Everdim?
Everswim.
Everswim, yeah. When it first came out, I could stay forever there, you know. I really loved it. It was, oh my God, the surroundings, the water.
There we go.
I think it's got ruined because they put them new mini travel things in. I think, you know, Everswim, you know, it was what it was because you used to have to swim all the way across that lake to the different places and stuff like that, and they've just made it so easy now.
I was working on trying to get the voice overlay part working for my stream so we can see who's talking.
Yeah, I got mine sorted.
If I would suggest where you put it, I would put it over the eye of Sauron to the left.
Yeah, I could do that. Usually I have my cam over there, but my cam is not working because I'm not at home.
Yeah, I've got to sort my camera out. I've got to get that sorted out badly. I've had a few people mention it to me about getting the camera sorted and what have you. And of course, now that I've had that particular message off Cordovan.
What do you need?
I've seriously got to try and get it sorted over next week or so.
Now I have to head back to Thornhead. I could head over to Forakel. Frozen Hell. I love that place.
I was never a great lover of it over there. Even when it first came out, you know, I just didn't really like it. And I think some of it was because of the way the travel was. You know, and you know, you couldn't get from place to place pretty easy. You know, you're having to manually ride or stuff like that, and it just put me off.
How can I be of service?
Yeah, and that's also what I liked, what they changed about the traveling. You can now see from each region where you can go to. In the past, you really needed to look at the names of the stables to see if you can go somewhere, and now it's listed by region, and it's much better. And they did a lot of travel hubs, like Rivendell, Bree, and 21st Hall, and more like that.
Well, it's like Rift. I mean, you've now got a stable up at the Rift. I'm sorry, but that's just wrong.
No way.
There's a stable up at the Rift, and that's cut out of all the fun of having to run the gauntlet to get up to the Rift, especially if you're one of these, because I'm part of a keen on Brandywine where we're level 50, and that just cuts out all the fun of getting up to the Rift.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. I mean, that's all part of the experience of doing the Rift, going there. Jeez. Well, if you're doing it, you can do it the old-fashioned way. Just ignore the stable, huh?
Oh, God, yeah. Definitely.
And what I do like about this freezing land is that you indeed get troubled by the cold, you know? You need to warm yourself up sometimes. That's pretty fun down here. And I died a lot here because I thought I could walk somewhere and then I...
Like in the water, for instance.
Yeah.
That water's chilly.
I guess they changed it now a little bit, because when it first came out, when you really hit the water, you died because of the freezing cold. Now you get the freezing and then you can still get out, right?
Only if you're really quick. It only takes 2 or 3 ticks to kill people.
Only if you're on level. If you're 105, you can literally swim right across that lake.
Do you guys remember the rotten cheese from the Barrow Downs?
Oh my gosh, yes. That was one of my favorite things today.
I still have 8 of them.
I've got 7 of them on a character on Landerball. I gotta pick up 3 more. I wanna do a test the healer type thing. Can you keep me alive through 10 Barrow Brie cheeses?
But that's another thing that they should make level dependent. Because if you're level 105, you know, you take that and it barely puts a dent in you. Now, if you're level 20 or, you know, 25, you know, that stuff, you know, it's going to cure you. You know, so you have to be on level to use it, to make it worthwhile sort of thing. You know, so that they need to try and change that. There's a few things in the game that they need to try and change, I think.
They also could implement, I don't think it will work because of the game mechanics, but that you can choose your level. Like, you have also instances that you can skill up, you know, but why can you not skill down, you know? If I want to play a level 25 instance, let me be level 25, you know?
Yeah. And that's what they do in a particular other game, where you get scaled down. If you go to a certain world or something like that, you know, because there's a big group of us that have gone over to play that game, and if you go onto a different world, you automatically get scaled down. So if you're level 70, for instance, yeah, fair enough, you've still got all the skills from the level 70, but you'll get scaled down to level 20, right? So your morale does drop down to like 1,000 morale.
Yeah, and your power does not survive all of all your skills, so you need to pick the low ones. Yeah, that's much better.
But I'm guessing that's just going to be something really, really hard to try and introduce, especially with the way the coding is within the different areas of the game.
Yeah, and but I also don't like they increased the level cap on and on and on, and now it's 105, I guess. But I don't know, since level 60, we cannot get any more skills. I think it's not really done. They should invent some more advanced skills, you know, just to have something to unlock, you know?
Yeah, I know as a burglar, I'd love some sort of AoE skill. Or something ranged, at least. I know as a burglar, you know, we can actually craft sort of like the throwing daggers and stuff like that. But I think we should have a skill that's a ranged skill, because it's horrible trying to run around sometimes. And you get these, like, one of the latest things they did was the quest to do to get like a flower basket, the herbless quests. And you go in there and you've got all these people in there, the hunters, the minstrels, lore masters and stuff like that, but hitting things at range. And before, as a burglar, before you can even get to them to try and tag them, they're dead. So you just got no chance. Unless it's empty in that little cave area, you can't do anything as a burg. You know, otherwise you have to switch which line that you're in, and then you need to play yellow line, because that's the only time you actually get range skills. You know, but even some of the range skills on a burg don't actually tag a mob, because if you use Addle, you know, which is a short cooldown and things like that, it doesn't tag a mob.
So they still have that inside the game. I didn't know that. I guess that when you were 35, you could do your books, right? To get special skills. It's still in the game? I don't even remember.
I'm trying to think which ones you're about. 35.
Yeah, special class skills. You have to buy 3 books and you have to complete deeds in order to get those.
Yeah. You still get them. That's like your level 50 skills and stuff like 50. That. But the thing is, you don't get skills for them anymore. You just get trait points, and then you get your skill. You know, you can get like the skills from the trait points and things like that. But there are certain classes. If you're a melee class, you know, you don't get range. And when you go into some areas with the DPS that some classes can actually do, but a range, you know, as a melee person, you've got no chance of getting close to them getting close to hit them.
Welcome, Atelevios.
You know, for them to actually count for you, unless you're actually in the group with the people that are hitting them.
I'm hoping to see them expand the hobby system.
They won't.
There's got to be more than just fishing.
Oh, they've talked about that for years. I remember when they first introduced that.
They only introduced that the same way, like they started with the chicken runs and stuff like that. It's only to test out the system with this personal instances for skirmishes and stuff like that.
Well, fishing actually got introduced with the area that you're in at the moment. Yeah.
I don't remember. So long time ago.
Fishing got introduced with Forest Shell because a couple of the quests, or one of the quests at least, was a fishing quest. And if I remember rightly, one of the areas that you go into from the book from Forest Shell is one of the areas where they wanted you to get like one of the items to do. You know, it was still part of fishing and stuff like that back then.
Yeah, I do remember that they, as soon as they introduced fishing, that they also put some festival quests in them that you need to catch a lot of fish.
Yeah, because it was in the Shire that you used to have to go for. You had to go to a particular fishing pool in the Shire.
Yeah, I remember those. And picking flowers.
Picking flowers should be a hobby.
Yeah, making daisy chains.
Yeah.
Or maybe something like woodwork, but then for furniture, you know? You can create your furniture for your homes.
There you go.
Yeah, I mean, there's many things that they could do. And I think the crafting system over the last couple of years especially has been really let down. It's like a weaponsmith. You know, my burglar was always a weaponsmith. And since they brought out legendary weapons, you know, when was the last time that you really had to craft an offhand weapon? You don't.
Never did it.
You never don't have to craft them now. You get them from the instances, you know. And my weaponsmith, I've got no use. Other than making shield spikes, there is no use for my weaponsmith. Absolutely nothing is worth making. You know, you can do berg marbles, for instance. They've got no use. Absolutely no use at the moment. And other than sort of like an extra stun, you know. The caltrops have always been a waste of time. You know. And you get mate caltrops at the moment. They only do 100 damage a tick. You know, and that's nothing when these mobs have sort of got like, you know, sort of like 70,000-80,000 morale. You know, so it's just like, ugh.
Yeah, but to be honest, the only professions that I found useful that were usable was the jeweler, the cook, and the one that makes the instruments for the minstrel. I guess it's a woodworker.
As a woodworker, right? Yeah.
The rest of the things I never used. I mean, the weaponsmith I never used. The farmer I didn't use, yeah, for my cook, but...
You know, but, you know, if you're a tier 2 raider like myself, even a woodworker's become pretty non-existent because, you know, you don't need the woodworker thing on a minstrel anymore, the class item, because you get it all from the raid. Yeah, and this is the thing, crafting has slowly become completely non-existent. Other than sort of doing essences, there's no use for crafting whatsoever.
Where are you now, by the way? Because this area looks very amazing and I don't remember where it is.
Everswim.
Yeah, on the bottom, you're going back to Everswim.
Yep.
I didn't remember that it was so heavily forest. You know, it's pretty relaxing to watch someone else play the game that you also like.
Your service and your families.
Alrighty, that finishes that one. I gotta head back to the Lone Lands. Finish the next one.
I am pleased to be made known to you.
Yeah, with questing, I'm cheating a lot because I'm using always this Mithra coins to get directly to the place where I need to be. Yeah, I'm a VIP, so I get so many points every month so that I can buy those Mithril coins cheap.
I've never used a Mithril coin whatsoever.
Yeah, but come on, if you if you have to travel... It's hard to travel from back to forth, back to forth, back to forth. Oh my god, not again.
That's what Swift travels for.
Yeah, but if, for instance, if you cannot find the person that you need to go to, and you see this nice blue symbol that you can use a Mithra coin, I'm using the Mithra coin.
I use my return to, and then use the Swift horses. It doesn't take that much longer. And I'm cheap.
What do you need?
Yeah, this region was very impressive, especially the puzzle quest, if I remember correctly. This is also the region with the turtle, right? Yeah. The turtle of Evendim. That was the first time that we had to bring a GM to kill the turtle for us because he was bugged. Yeah, that's also something that I found very strange. When the European servers were still in
Greetings,
Europe with
friend.
Coldmasters, the GMs of Coldmasters were much more helpful than the GMs of the Turbine back in the days.
Yeah, and you used to get that weekly reset as
what
well.
What can I do
Thursday.
For you?
Huh. Yep. New festival going on that I've never done. I might have to check that out after I clean out these quests.
The Winter Quest is going on, right? Yeah.
Treasure Camp.
Okay.
Whatever that is. Yule Fest has been over for a while now.
That's the little mining one. It's pretty good, that is.
Uh-oh. It's not good.
Seven amounts are really nice.
Sure of your game went. Whoa. Ah, no, you're back.
So, what about you, Stronky? If you're in EU, I'm guessing Scandinavia somewhere.
I'm in the Netherlands. I'm Dutch.
How can I be of service?
I'm guessing you're an old snowball player.
Yeah, I'm not tired, and it's almost weekend, so why not?
So, did you use to play on a snowboard?
Did I use what?
Snowboard? Was you snowboard before Evernight? I'm guessing you're Evernight.
No. I started on snowboard when they were still in Europe. And then part of my kin left to Lorien, because we wanted to roleplay. And yeah, then the service went to America and we stayed in Lorien. And we were hoping that the service would physically move also back to Amsterdam, but they don't do it.
Yeah, I remember there was all that talk about them coming back over. Oh, to be honest, even I was hoping they was going to.
I wouldn't expect them to move out of New Jersey for many, many years at least.
No, there was a lot of talk about the European service coming back over to Europe. And even that was being talked about at the time by Turbine. You know, they were saying about moving the European servers back over here.
Yeah, they already bought a new hardware, but they are using it for a different game.
So for a lot of European players, that was a bit of a kick in the teeth when they still didn't move them back over.
I got a ping over the 120. That's not normal if you do raids and PvP. It's way too high. You're lagging like hell.
Yeah, I mean, mine is normally around about 90. But the last week or so, mine's been sort of 100 and somewhat, and I don't know what's going on.
But I have to say, you are meeting more people around than I am doing on Lorien when I'm traveling and doing quests. I hardly see anyone.
This is Brandywine on this one.
Okay, maybe that's it.
I usually play on Landerval and there's even more people there.
Yeah, I'm still thinking about moving my character. Because I have no one to play it on Lorien.
Get yourself over to Evernight. There's lots and lots over there.
Yeah, where you're going now, that was the first zone that I hated to play. Especially with the yellow lady, or the orange lady, what was it? The pink lady, the red lady? Those quests there.
Well, in the Everstream area, it used to be the blue lady.
No, it's the above those swamp with all those trees.
How can I be of service?
And red stuff. Those quests there, I really hate them.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. That was out in...
Yeah, there on the
Agamawa. Agamawa, just north of the... Oscarith.
Yeah, that one. I really hated those quests. And is there also a travel point there? Did I see correctly? Yeah. What? Okay.
No, you've always had one at Oscarith. But there shouldn't be one at Agamal.
Oh no, it's a cellar. Fender. And this is the area where I first got out of bounds to visit the Hidden Hobbit village. That was very funny to do. I was the kind of guy that really tested the limits of the server. I always humping things that I should not hump. And the GMs were not happy with me because I totally crashed my character in the beta, and I had to start over again because my character was beyond repair. Yeah. But they all fixed it. They all fixed the houses there and the stone walls, so you cannot go and get out of bounds anymore. Such a shame.
All right, I gotta figure out how to get up on top of the lore span from here. There's
The lore span is the bridge.
Yeah, it's that bridge right there, but I gotta go over to this other bridge to get to it.
Yeah, you need to be, there's the camp where you can get quests.
I believe there's a set of stairs up right here.
Yeah. It's, yeah, keep going forwards there. There's this thing on the left-hand side, a little cut through, and then you got some stairs. And then there's some quest givers up at the top, and then you just carry along that pathway.
They made it easier. Back in the days, you couldn't get there. There was no stairs.
No. One of the easiest ways to go through it was through the castle area, but so you've actually got the two ways through now.
Yeah, with all the wargs and spiders, right?
Yeah.
Here's my strongbox. Back to the Forsaken Inn. Waiting for them to give us a moose mount so we can ride a moose.
A moose?
A moose! We can ride a goat, why not a moose?
I have no idea.
Then they can give us Ranger as a high elf exclusive class.
Yeah, they should ride mooses.
That's right. With a pack of wolves following them.
Yeah, well, one thing I know for a fact that you can do as a high off is you can play a Cappy.
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to get on Bull Roarer. I actually don't have the client.
That's not on Bull Roarer yet. I think that's going to be update 21 when you go into Mordor itself. That'll be the next X-Pack.
I guess we have to pay for the expansion pack, right?
More than likely.
Something to spend all those Lotro points on that you get for VIP.
Yeah.
Unless you've already spent them.
Well, I'm still 7,000. Yeah, I played a long time. I didn't play for a long time, so every month 500 points, yeah. It's ka-ching.
I went VIP for 1 month.
Yeah, you told me. And how was it?
It was okay. I like the mailbox anywhere thing. But what I found interesting was I actually got 500 Lotru points at the beginning and another 500 Lotru points at the end for my 1 month. I ended up getting 1,000.
That's nice.
Yeah, because I give you the 500 just to start with. But I'm lucky because I'm lifetime anyway.
Are you also a lifetimer?
Yeah.
I'm a lifetimer over on DDO, but not on Lotro.
I paid 150 euro for it, and that was exclusive the game. And the stupid thing is that I also bought for two of my friends also the lifetime. And those friends are not playing anymore.
Yeah, but the biggest issue is, I mean, fair enough, I mean, I've got my money back and everything like that, but when Moria came out, they actually reduced the price down to, like, 50 at the time. I mean, I paid nearly £200, £250.
You solved the message? Oh, let me see that treasure!
And then, that's a couple of years later, the end they brought now? Out Moria.
I will keep looking for the last time that you and you should see if Unlove needs help with anything.
You reduced the price all the way down to 50 English sterling.
Yeah, so unbelievable. But I remember that I bought a different version. You had the Lifetime Membership and you had the Founders Edition. And I bought the Founders Edition inclusive the Lifetime Membership.
Yeah.
And the Founder Edition that gave you access to, I guess, 14 days early access and a lot of extras.
And it cost extra. It was about £250, I think. Something like that.
Looks like Zoo Spy and Chat's lifetime as well.
Oh, thanks for the... Yeah, Zoo Spy. Hey, Zoo Spy. Thanks for the Twitch TV, but I'm not streaming now. I'm watching you. Did you also play in Alpha on the US servers before they went to the Europe?
I did, yeah. I got in at the end of the Alpha, so I was around for Alpha Beta.
Yeah, me too. Then you also play this game for more than 10 years, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, we are the old ones here. The diehards.
Yeah, I've only ever had one break from the game, which was last year. I had about 6 month break, something like that, 6-7 month break from the game. But other than that, I've been there, you know, through thick and thin.
I actually didn't know any of it existed before 2009.
If I remember correctly, it was November 2006 when the Alpha started in the US. They only had one server, and by accident I got it. And it was very funny because they only allowed normal US players. So I had to use a VPN connection to enable my connection, and then I could play with my normal IP in Europe. And that was very funny. But yeah. It got me hooked directly. And the fun thing
did he need something?
Did you also have that your characters could travel through hubs where you can level, get items and get gold and get traits and skills and stuff like that? It was like one cheating hub.
I
knew it! Invisible letters!
I know, but you get it now, where you can do that. And what I find is, when it comes to the Gift of Valor, Box of Valor, and things like that, I mean, for myself, you know, I've done all these areas, got loads and loads, you know, and I get bored of doing them, and I think some of my characters are stuck on like level 65 or 75 and stuff like that because I've done them countless times, and I just sort of think, why should I have, you know, I've done it sort of like 4 or 5 times. Why should I have to do it 8, 9, 10, 11 times? You know, so I'm glad that they brought out the Box of Valor and stuff like that. But the biggest problem is you do get people come in the game, and they do get these items, all right? And they've not got a clue what skills do what.
Yeah, but the reason why they did it in the beginning, because they also need people to end, to test end.
What do you need?
Content, you know? If they would wait until all leveled up normally, they would have like, okay, we are not there yet. How the hell are we going to test it? So they offered a couple of people to go to the cheat area where you can directly went to level 50, you know, with all the skills and all the shit. It was indeed, like you said, you have no idea what you're doing. It's just trial and error, but they needed people there, you know?
Yeah. I mean, that's on Ball Aura, you know, but when it comes to the actual game itself, you know, you do get a lot of players that, you know, will buy these things and then they don't know their classes and stuff like that. And I think, you know, you get a lot of us at old times that do get a little bit, what's it with that?
Tedious, yeah, it gets tedious. That's why, I only stick with one character. It's my minstrel, and that one is leveling up to be 105, and then I think, okay, it's good enough for me. Like I said, I don't have people to play it with anyways. But maybe one day I will start a new character from the start, just to see how much has changed, because they revamped a lot of areas, like starter quest. It's flowing more directly to the next parts. I remember in the past that well, once you were done in the area, then you were stuck. There were no more quests. So you think, okay, where do I need to go? And by accident, you find another quest hub. Now they really have the last quest is pointing you to the next quest hub, like it should be, you know?
Yeah, they've done a good job on clearing some of that stuff out, especially through Moria, because that was one of the first ones that they actually sorted out, because that was a nightmare to try and negotiate back in the day.
Yeah, I remember Mines of Moria. I was the first of my kin that was on the other side, because I was using my part of my friends, my condom shield, to run through the whole Moria instance. I remember that I was so happy that I was reaching the other side. Then I was there, okay, where's Lothlorien? No, you could not reach it. You were one-shot it as soon as you came too close, because the area was not there yet. Yeah, that was funny with the minstrel. And does the game still have those special mobs? When you kill them, they are dropping a special fur that you can use in a taxidermist to make a thing for your house?
Some do, yeah.
Okay, it's still there. Okay, good. And those quests in Estilden, you had a quest giver there that you also need to kill special named mobs all over the place. One was a worm, one was a dragon, one was I don't know.
Yeah, you still get them. The warbands. No, not the warbands.
I don't remember where they were for. I guess for the legendary weapons, right?
Back then it was. It's not anymore. You can actually kill so many warbands and get yourself a pocket item when you're level 100. But now, because you're level 105, you've got different pockets.
I believe he said,
I knew you would.
I believe he said he was from the Netherlands, Pontus Hurricane.
Listen! The true master treasure seeker's coming out! I will learn from Haley if she'll have me as a student.
Stronky's from
our
the
treasure hunt
That's
is
correct.
At an end, and I am satisfied with its conclusion. Our own journey must continue.
It's a good thing that you're paying the attention to the chat. I'm only watching you play, man. I'm not looking at the chat.
I watch the chat in my broadcaster stream in the bottom left corner there.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So you're also using a bot that is putting... Oh yeah, MoobBot, I see it already.
Yeah, I don't pay much attention to MoobBot.
Are you going to the trolls now? Yeah, I guess so.
Heading to the last bridge. Talk to Bingo there. Want to advance the Bingo quest chain up to up into the Misty Mountains probably. And I'll leave it there for now. I still need to head up to Angmar and get that working. I got an epic up there that I haven't completed yet. The one.
What do you think about Teletubby Land? I hope that you know what I'm meaning.
No.
It's the south of Angmar.
Because.
With all the worms and. Where you cannot pass through in the middle if you don't finish book 5 or 6.
Yeah, that's what I gotta work on.
Stones. Okay, yeah. I call it Teletubby Land because of all the strange colors and stuff.
Ah. I never watched Teletubby, so... I know it was a thing, but I've never watched it.
I had to.
Sorry to hear that.
Well, I'm 42, so I saw a lot of children programs back in my days. But Teletubbies is not that old, I know, but I also have nieces and
we should look for a good place to stop for the night.
Fortunately, my kids got past that age just before Teletubbies came out. I did have to endure Barney and the other one and whatever, so... But...
Hey, she moved!
Let us find a spot we can camp for the night.
I remember that she was on the left side of the bridge. Okay.
The journey has been a tiring one already, and Bingo is ready to camp for the night in the wild of the Trollshaws.
Ooh, travel now. That's... Ooh. No, they must have changed the zone. I never remember that the Trollshaws was so bushy and tree-like. It was also so empty when I was playing in there.
Trollshaws is a forest. It's loaded with trees.
Yeah, well, when I played there, I had a very bad video card. Maybe that was it. So how many people are watching the stream now?
According to XSplit, there's 18. And according to IRC, there's 24 people in chat, including 7 ops, or moderators. A lot of those are probably lurkers. And one moose.
You really like your moose, huh?
That's what was said in chat, and one moose. Goes by the name of Gussie.
Okay.
One fussy moose.
I have Gussie moose, there you are. Yeah, the chat is a little bit slow. What the hell was coming there from the right? Was it a little squirrel?
Nocturnal crawler. Thingamajiggy. Okay. Oh, good. So you didn't hear all of our other moose talk. Our moose ranger related talk.
So did you already pass the quest line where you see Gollum for the first time?
Nope.
That's after this, right?
It's gotta be way after this. I got a level 63 and I haven't seen it. Again, I'm still in the corner, Gussie.
Level 45 is the first quest that you get from the where you see Gollum for the first time. I'm pretty sure, because I helped my girlfriend back there in that quest area with the lore master. Ooh, troll!
And then a rat.
Oh, very big rat. I blame the tree lurker. He's calling for those animals. And you are just...
It's all the ranger's fault.
Yeah.
Oh no, the campfire's gone out.
It's still there. Oh no, not anymore. What?
At last,
I fell asleep.
The sun rises. Ooh, pretty waterfall.
That was quite a restful sleep. I have been studying my map. And I know where I want to go next.
Find the glade of three smiling figures. I've seen that before. That's three trolls. Stone trolls. I guess he's always putting me in the corner.
I guess he's meaning the stream, right?
Hmm? She doesn't like the way that I decorated her her house. Speaking of which, I have to get her some more decorations for her house. Got more decorations in her house than I've got in mine.
Well, you know that you should also always let women decorate the house, otherwise it will be an IKEA mess.
It's got quite moosey decorations.
Moosey Gussie Moosey Decorations Inc. Incorporated, huh?
It's definitely got a Moose Lodge theme to it.
We want proof. Show us.
You've grown to like your moose decorations? Her house is literally like peppered wall to wall in moose head decorations. It was Evil Twin's idea. I only contributed a little bit.
Well, I guess. Ah, you're on the level here. Over level, I mean.
Oh, yeah. All of these areas I'm over level for. But because I'm using a tortoise stone to cap my level. I'm just cleaning up stuff that I don't get credit for anyway on XP-wise. Just get Ds or whatnot.
I guess you're missing where those trolls are.
It's right up here.
Yeah, and if you walk further, you have that... it's only spawning when you have the quest, right? That named animal there.
There's a bingo here.
Oh no! Ah. Do you see that?
And Willem Whisker. Hey Willem, let's release Willem Whisker. Well, he's not named yet.
Oh, I am glad the lynx is free. I hope he recovers from his injuries.
You're doing a lore master now, right?
Oh, yeah.
And do you also do the extra quest for all the extra pets?
I do. I think I've got most of them at this point, up to where I am.
Right then, I'm gonna bid thee a good night. It's, you know, getting on. Well, it's just after 3:30 in the morning. So.
Oh, it's only 10:30 at night. It's early.
I'm having a nighty night.
It's 5:00 almost, man.
So I shall see y'all later.
Have a good night, Beck.
Good night.
I only have two pets, and that's the swan and the cat.
Yeah, I don't remember which ones I've got yet. I don't think I have much on this character, but on my other character, I've done most of them.
I do not mean to worry you, but we are being followed.
I like
followed.
The turtle the best. How it's walking. Took, 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 took.
Maybe Willem Whisker is hungry. What? He needed a name, didn't he?
Collect venison in the troll shots. Let's go kill 3 deer so we can feed Willem Whisker. One.
You know, that's funny. You have people in front of you. Like I said, when I'm playing, I never see other people. I'm like alone in the world.
2, 3. Oh What, Gussie? I have to feed Will and Whisker so I can advance the Bingo Bop in the quest line. Come on now.
There's someone on fire there.
I have been thinking it over, and I think we should allow Willem to tag along with us.
Find the entrance to Rivendell, the Hidden Valley. I think I can do that.
You're already there, right?
Let's see here. Which direction's Rivendell? This way.
That's not hard. Ah, that's the other way around, man. You should have walked.
Shorter from here.
I remember when I was walking this, and I was like, oh my god, I found Rivendell. All the quests were too high, but okay.
Gussie, it's okay. I apologize to their mother after.
It was a digital goose. Moose. It all looks so purple there.
Purple? Yeah, it does look kind of purple in the stream, doesn't it?
I guess it's the time of the day. It's night, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
What purpose brings your party to the Hidden Valley?
Really? This elf believes I am a danger to the peace of Rivendell?
Then our new friend, Will and Whisker?
I am excited to explore, but right now my stomach is rumbling.
And again a travel now. Oh, good luck.
Head to the Homely House.
Ah, such a shame you just used to travel.
Yeah, it's okay. It's easier going downhill than up. Geronimo!
You die if you do that. You know that, huh?
This is swift travel.
Yeah, swift die travel.
Death taxi! See? I'm right at the bottom of the hill. I'm good.
What is that blue, blue thing appearing above your task bar?
Oh, that is buff bars. Yeah, I took the death taxi. Brings me right to the bottom of the hill next to the bridge. Swift travel.
Ah. Cheating the mechanics, huh?
I knew where the spawn point was. Down the hill is forward progression.
Yeah, but you are going, you went the wrong way then.
That's all good. What, Gussie?
Yeah, they changed Rivendell also. Long time ago.
Suggestion for the Titan Bar. Other than rewriting the wallet app to include vials of extract and the fishing part and the new direction speed part and... Oh, what was the other one I was going to add? The hope? I've got a few things that I'm working on adding to it and rewriting. Elrond, he's upstairs.
He's up.
Various tokens. Are those various tokens in the wallet? Because if they're in the wallet, I'm already doing a complete rewrite of the wallet to include all wallet currencies. Yeah, those are in the wallet.
Are you making your own plugins?
It's going to be all wallet stuff. Actually, it's the Titan Bar up here on top. The developer for that kind of abandoned it, and then somebody else took over and then abandoned it. It had been untouched for a year and a half, and I tried to get in touch with both of the previous developers with no success. And I said the heck with it, and I just started updating it myself.
But I was talking about this blue bar appearing above
Dark
your...
Dark days are coming.
Your shortcuts.
Yep, that's buff bars.
So if you're falling down, you get buffs?
I don't know what the buffs might have been. Broken leg, maybe?
Okay, yeah, that could be.
Yeah, that's buff bars. There you go. Find Bilbo in the Hall of Fire.
And then you're gonna get the quest of Bilbo's riddle. Oh no, that is Goblin Town, right?
I don't know if I've done Goblin Town yet. I think I have.
No. Goblin Town is Bilbo's buttons. Here you get Bilbo's quest for his riddle.
I don't know if I've done that yet on this one. All right, there's Bilbo.
It's Bilbo ahead. Baggins, the famed adventurer from up Hobbiton way.
You really love to fall, and I guess you're always jumping on stairs and chairs and sofas just to get a quicker way, huh?
Yep, I'm not big for taking my time to go around and go down the stairs one at a time. Jump off the ledge and call it good.
Yeah, remind me not to find you in my home. You crash my couches and my stairs and my...
Hey, I'll get there quickly. Find the Market of Rumidel. Spire of Meeting.
You got the quest of the riddle.
Find all of this stuff.
Yeah, you know that people like stuff.
People do like stuff.
About stuff.
Stuff. Stuff is here, stuff is there, stuff is flying through the air.
My stuff. The whole thing you are creating is to get more stuff. And then you go, and then you need to have a place for your stuff. And all you see is other people's stuff. Reminds me of a comedy act by this guy from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. I guess you don't know.
I know of Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, yes.
Yeah, and then if you, the guy, the main guy from the future, that is a comedian. He died already, but I forgot his name, but he made a nice video about my stuff, your stuff. People only need stuff, and you need to find places with stuff. It's pretty amazing. And I also remember that you had to use scrying pools. Do you remember that?
Nope. I don't think I've used a reflecting pool yet.
No, it was called scrying pools.
That was the
only way to get into PvP. Yeah, George Carlin, that's the one. Yeah. If you also can find the link of the video of this stuff that I was mentioning, it would be nice. George Carlin. My stuff. Hey, Gus. Yeah. It's the buff. It's now the broken leg thingy that I saw. You're right.
It's a good buff. I get that buff a lot.
I hate that buff. You know why I hate that buff? That sound that it makes.
Crack! When I hear that sound, I know that I'm still alive.
I remember the time where you could cheat a certain quest in Moria, where you can fall through the well. If you did it with a timely step, you could survive the fall, and you would be in the down in the waterworks. Do you remember that part?
Nope. I've actually only been playing 9 or 10 months.
You have not been to Moria yet?
Yep, I have on my 63 on Landerval.
I guess you went speed through it, huh?
I spent a good 10, 12 levels in there. I didn't like it all that much, so I got out it fairly as quickly as I could. I did go back and clean some stuff up, but...
Yeah, did you get all the standings with the miners?
I believe so.
They also get a special goat, right? The goat. Do you have the goat?
I don't remember. I may have. Crack. No. Ah, there we go. Delayed reaction.
Well, you're not dead yet on the stream that I see. There you go. No, not yet.
There's the waterfall. What's the other one? The Spire of Meeting. Remember where that one is. Right there. Okay, so it's on my way to the waterfall. Must be that little hut.
Can hardly read the text. Anyways.
There's Bingo.
There's also a quest giver here that can give you a lot of quests from things that you already did before. Yeah, he's there. He was there.
Return the map. To Bingo in the Hall of Fire. Oh goody, I get to get dismounted. Why can't I ride my horse?
Your horses are afraid of water. And inside the last homely house, there's a lot of water.
I don't know. Should be able to ride my horse in the house.
There is something very familiar about this map.
You can ride your horse in the 21st hall.
I have so many questions about his adventures and his riding both. I wonder what Bilbo would think of my account so far.
And there he goes again, walking over the table. Unbelievable.
Sit down on the table and wait.
Yeah, and there the quest is coming from Bilbo's riddle.
No, come on, Bilbo. Not.
And now you're sitting on the table. Oh my god, your manners.
I
By the way, this room is very impressive with all these reflecting sources and the windows, and especially when it's light outside.
Yeah, I've seen that. All the light coming through the windows. Oh yeah, I haven't done any inventory management. I haven't even looked at my inventory today. Not much to look at. Still got, what, 29 empty slots? Test, test, test.
It's just for the people that want to see that part
George,
that I was talking.
George Carlin thing.
Bilbo didn't like it.
Yeah.
Oh no, we have to do something.
Now that's funny. I jumped while sitting down on the table. Defeat dangerous creatures in the high moors or giant valley. Take some notes on the parchment at the Ford of Bruinen.
So this is the riddle quest.
Notes by the author. That's what it's called. I think the riddles were back in Oskaruth.
No. You still get Bilbo's riddle. And you also get to have... I guess you already had it, where you have to take Frodo for a walk.
Oh, that's coming up in a couple chapters. Haven't quite gotten to walking Frodo yet. He's a good boy. He goes potty like he's supposed to.
Yeah, Frodo is not that smart. Sam is the real hero.
Actually, I think I want to go fishing in the river. Can I go fishing in the river from here?
I don't know. I would not go in there. I guess you will drown.
Must be facing a body of water. I am facing a body of water. What are you talking about? Must not be close enough. I'm too high up on the bridge.
Jump down. You can fish in the water.
Yeah. It's a pain to get out of, though, from there. I've been in there before.
This is new. I never had to fish in Rivendell.
I don't have to fish here. I just feel like doing some fishing.
Okay. I need to get me something to drink. Be right back. I'm back.
Woo!
And what you thought about this link that I sent? Gussy Moose. Nice, huh?
Char, a bitterling, and a minnow so far. Nothing useful. Still waiting to get some good cooking fish. Goldfish.
Goldfish.
For the car. You know, you'd think in a waterfall you'd find some nice salmon or something. Nice river trout, brook trout, something.
Nah. And all of a sudden, you are missing a lot of skills in your skill bar, or is that on purpose?
Oh, that's my other skill bar. You've got two complete sets for your skill bar and the first three tool hot bars. An offensive and a defensive. I use the defensive for crafting and fishing and whatnot, and then the offensive for actually questing.
Yeah, good idea.
I suppose if I was more dexterous, I could use them both for actual questing, but switching hotbars doesn't work very well for me. Evened in blue. Coupon code I'm blue. It's a freebie of the week.
As long as you don't fish out bicycles and stuff like that, I think you're okay.
Oh, rusty dagger. At least I'm not getting any weeds today, so far.
Knock on wood. Yeah, I'm going to bed. It's 5:10, so...
Am I fishing putting you to sleep?
No. I'm just tired. Good night, everyone.
Have a good night. Oh, there's my weeds. There we go. Hit 21, and that's the cap for today. We've caught, let's see here, 5 chars, 8 bitterlings, 5 minimos, 4 goldfish, 5 rusty daggers, and 4 weeds. It's a productive day at fishing. I do say myself, say so myself. Let me update my notes. I want to put a space in after 21. So you can only increase 10 levels per day. Does it ever change? Goldfish, dagger, minnow, bitterling, char, and weeds. Okay, so I haven't gotten anything above it at that point. All right, so that was my fishing expedition of the day. I am heading to Borbrunnen. Feel free to join me in chat. I am in the official servers live stream channel. There it is. The official, unofficial Lord of the Rings Online Discord server. Pop on over there and join the,
What do you need?
Live stream channel. Slow ride to Thornhead, that way I can hop off at the forge. The Fort of Brunnen. I wish I had some candy tonight, but I don't. You'd make me a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, I suppose. Ooh, I can go get my hot peppers. That sounds delicious. Actually, even better sounds like... that I can't have because my daughter already ate it. She already ate my cereal. Okay. Peppers. Yes, I'm eating on stream. I've fished, I'm eating on stream. I don't have enough inventory to worry about inventory management. The only thing left to do to make this a Big Ed Mustafa approved stream is to do some crafting. Let's do some inventory management.
Sweelad Melon, how may I be of service?
Boom, inventory managed. Excuse me. One more monster. One more dangerous creature. That's a scary morfly. My friend, Sirion, has come online. Whoever that person is, I have no idea. But I love it when people on my friends list come online. Platinum. Leroy Jenkins! Hey, I survived the first fall. Survived. them some spicy peppers. I love it. Marks in your silver box.
Very good, my friend. This will add some spice to my account.
A lovely day, isn't it? Added some spice to my account,
too. My journey has only just begun. Where should we go next? I do not want to lull my future readers to sleep.
Misty Mountains. Okay, so that's where I wanted to go with that one. And I want to leave Bingo Buff in there. Now I need to head back to Angmar. Book 5. Book 6, Fires in the North. Sorcerer's Doom. There we go. Oh, it's book 6 that I need. Where I got Eris. Head to Estolin. Here, I should be able to ride to Angmar, right?
How can I be of service?
Okay. Almost there. Is Lucho dead? Not even close. Transition from Warner Brothers Turbine to Sony Entertainment, Daybreak, Standing Stone Games has increased interest in the game substantially in the last few months, and it's been noticeable. Extremely noticeable. I can understand that. It was confusing and difficult for me the first time that I tried to play it about 4 or 5 years ago. I don't think I made it to level 15 before I just said the heck with it. It's just not worth it for me. So last year, 10, 11 months ago, I had some friends that were playing. So I promised them that I would give it another try. And here I am streaming it, playing right along. I've got a max level of 63 for a character. It goes up to 105, but still plugging right along, having a good time, so. I certainly encourage you to give it another try if you haven't
Greetings.
Done it in a while. There we go. No indicator that I needed to do that. We're back on book 6 now. Okay. It's a long ride. Let's go for it. Check out the Discord channel. You can actually chat with me live in the live stream channel on stream here. There's also a lot of people that you can chat with text, and you can get a good feel for what would be a good server for you to give a try. Based on the time of day that it is, I'm guessing that you're going to want a East Coast / European server. People that are typically up. Earlier in the day, or maybe you want a West Coast server, or where the people that play on it are West Coast people. The key is to always be chugging right along with the content. If you slow down to deed and pick up skill points and whatnot, it's going to take a lot longer to level. You can level really, really quickly if you don't care about catching all the skill points. Speaking of skill points, I haven't checked mine in a while. I don't have any. Okay. Don't see me, don't see me, don't see me, don't see me. Leave me alone, leave me alone, leave me alone. Keep forgetting that he's up here. Roving threat that hangs out up there. So I guess the first question is, what time of day is it for you right now? And then the next question is going to be, what is your playstyle? Do you like role-playing? Do you like specific type of just going in and beating everything down? What makes games fun for you? It's almost midnight, so you're East Coast. Brandywine is good. Landerval is also good. Lots of trash in here. Tumble poof. Run, shoo, run. Not at all. Nope, Bull Roarer is currently not online. Yes, it does. Brandywine also has a 50 cap guild. Play it again. The one that I'm currently running. Where the idea is to hit level 50 cap, take your time going through getting your D's or whatever, and run the rift at level that it was intended to be run at. There's a couple options on Brandywine, depending on what kind of play you want to do. And both of those kins actually have private channels on the official, unofficial LOTRO Discord server. So if you get in either one of them, there's a specific chat channel for those kins to talk about things on the official server. The official, unofficial server. I need to look up how Wrath works for Bjorning. See how it compares with power.
How can I be of service?
How can you be of service indeed? Power regen, power morale. Completely different. Completely different how? Where am I from? I am from the East Coast. I'm actually from New England. I am 3 hours ride from where Standing Stone Games is, where the game is developed. More morale. Oh, I bet that's where the hitch up is. I'd have to mathematically figure out what Wrath is. Bjorning was introduced after the API, and the API was never retroactively adapted to include Wrath. That's what the issue is going to be for that one. Less vitality. That one doesn't help me any, so it's. I want a little bit more morale and dump the power and power regen. I guess.
What do you need?
yearning. I'm guessing wrath is kind of like ki. Do you get a certain amount of wrath per ability? I'll have to look into how it's generated and if those things are mentioned in the combat log or not. I might be able to calculate it based on the combat log for when those skills are activated, assuming that they're not interrupted.
An army of Dunedain and Hillmen from Ohaya passed into the eastern reaches of Angmar, only to be caught in the dire trap of Ramus Deluan. Though the secret of the stones has been revealed, no sign of Golodir, the ranger who led them, has yet been found. It can only be hoped that some part of Golodir's army has survived, and that they are able to hinder the advances of Angmar.
Sorry if that was loud. Can I get there now? Pretty sure I can figure out how to calculate that based on the combat log. But it is going to take a huge amount of figuring out. The issue is going to be figuring out which effects. What text is produced from which effects it generates, how much per effect, and how quickly it drains, both based on use and over time. So there's a lot of mechanics to it, which means that there's a lot of things that I gotta factor in when trying to calculate it manually based on combat log. Let's see if we're gonna die instantly. Burns! It burns my soul! I survived! Yay! Now I can get these last three points, hook points up here too. There could be something with allies that affect it as well.
What do you want?
Nice.
A shadow is on my spirit. Might you spare a moment of your time?
I'll have to look into it sometime. I got so many things I need to work on. It isn't easy being green. Wow, it's already midnight. Yeah, I've been up since early this morning, though. I had to go to the doctor's this morning for them to run some tests and tell me that I'm low on vitamin D. It's been causing blackout spells. I have to go pick up a prescription for vitamin D tomorrow. Fun. What does the frog say? Ribbit, bibbit, 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 bit. I forgot I did that so I can actually click on my mouse to pull up the map.
How can I be of service? What do you need?
Book 7.
What do you need? Would you do something for me?
Ragdoll. Outside, I think. I want to go over here. Ior Leon's camp. It's the last one I have to pick up out here. Then I'll have the entire northern area of the map completed. Down to Aragon. Where does that pop me out? Okay. I want to get to that last explorer point. That last stable master. know that I'll survive that, but I'm gonna give it a try. Oh, I survived. Get me a new horsey. Actually, get one with a few more hit points. 50 more hit points is a couple more hits. Go pick up Rockon. Ouch, ouch. Oh, this is going to be so painful. Can they not follow me through there? Apparently they don't follow me through there. Not as bad as I thought it would be. I should get me a new horse and heal up. couple rangers. Woo! Free peoples! I made it. Take care of their... I can take advantage of the horsies here.
What do you need?
Oh, so I can't use their horses because I need acquaintance standing with the Council of the North. And I am at neutral with the Council of the North.
My heart cannot sing today.
Eldgang?
Will you stay a moment and learn of my troubles?
Stay a moment.
Will you stop and hear my accursed tale?
I already have Eldgang, don't I? No, it's a new one. Okay, let's add them here. Eldgang. There we go. Don't need kindred. But I need what?
Greetings.
Acquaintance. That must be the first tier, the 10,000 tier. Or the 20,000 tier. How do I pick up? Down the hill. So I can do the rift. Thing here I'm supposed to use, but I don't know what it is. Oh, it's within the rift. Okay, so I have to go into the rift for that. One of the originals.
What can I do for you?
Erdun, huh? Lone Lands.
Come and stay a moment, friend. At your service, and your families. I am at your service. Well met, friend. At your service and your families. Well met, friend. I am at your service. Greetings, traveler! At your service and your families. Well met, friend. Greetings, traveler. Will you stay a moment?
Doesn't seem particularly exciting to me. Then again, I am extremely tired and it's almost 1 o'clock in the morning here, so... I think I'm going to talk to this cave claw. Oh, where's Halathor Goldeneye? Over here. Talk to this guy.
I am at your service.
Buckberries. Feed this cave claw, and then I'm going to call it a night. Alrighty. Have a good night, everybody. I will be back on next week at the same time, 9 p.m. Eastern, Thursday night. I am also on Tuesday morning at 8 a.m. Eastern on DDO stream channel for DDO Wiki Talk. And I've been on quite frequently on my personal channel. Let me throw a link up in chat. I've been on my personal channel quite frequently recently. Be sure to give that a follow and check it out. I'm almost at the 200 follower mark. When I do, there's a poll going, but it currently looks like I'm going to be doing some giveaways. I have a few Lotro point codes and some DDO point codes and starter pack for DDO and I don't know what else, but we'll see. I'll figure out something. I'll probably give out 3 gifts, maybe a starter pack, a DDO point code, and a Lotro point code in a short 3-hour stream, 1 gift an hour type thing. Everybody have a great night, and I will see you later.